know, burgers these days are just bigger and higher and fancier and hipper. And I'm just amazed how they can come up with to reinvent this fast food favorite. And of course, I'm this girl who loves challenges, and I'm gonna create something different, a twist, that I'm gonna make it fantastical, that is gonna be worth calling gourmet. So today, I'll be making, hold on to your seats, kapit lang, Wagyu burger with foie gras, truffled mayo with glazed onions and mushrooms. You know, just with the title, I'm already salivating. All right, are you excited? This is A Pinch of Portia. You know, there are just so many things going on with this burger we'll be making today. Australian Wagyu beef, your foie gras, your truffled mayo, and then we got also our roasted garlic mustard, and then balsamic glaze with our onions and mushrooms. It's amazing, believe me. You know, I just got so inspired when I went to the marketplace by restaurants, seeing all these ingredients available. I'm pretty sure, you know, my crew is all waiting for this Wagyu burger. So let's start this. First, I'm gonna teach you how to create the dressings. Truffle mayo is basically just mayonnaise and truffle oil. So I have here like 2 tablespoons of mayonnaise and then a bottle of truffle oil. So just a few drops, you don't want it to be too strong. One, oops, that's a lot. And then just mix it together. That's it. You got this nice, fragrant mayo for your burger, okay? Very simple. Okay, next, we also have our Dijon mustard with roasted garlic. Here, I got this in restaurants, but of course, you can make this at home. Just have, again, 2 tablespoons or a tablespoon of mustard, Dijon, and then I roasted some garlic. I'm just gonna mash these into this mustard and then add a pinch of sugar, and then that's it. You've got this really nice flavor of your mustard and your roasted garlic. Okay, so we just mash this together here. Next, we have our balsamic glaze. This is where we're gonna get all that sweetness from. You can also find this at the supermarket, but if you wanna make one on your own at home, just balsamic vinegar onto your pan and then reduce it until it's syrupy. That's just it. Okay, so we're good with our dressing. Let's start with our meat. I'm using Australian Wagyu beef. Now, this is richer in flavor, a bit pricey, but lower in cholesterol. And the good thing about this beef is that it is available at the marketplace by restaurants. Okay, so I have here 1 kilo of our Wagyu beef. Next, we're gonna add in our red onion, finely chopped, and then our garlic, around 5 cloves, finely minced, and then 2 tablespoons of breadcrumbs just to put them all together. And lastly, a piece of egg, right? This is gonna be a bit messy because I'll be using my hands to mix all of these. With this ball of meat, I can make 4 huge patties with this one. Okay, my burger patties are set. All we gotta do is gonna put my patties in there. Make sure to put it on the pan. Make sure to put it when your pan is really hot. Hold on, my patties are really big. And it should be on low heat. Now we're just gonna flip this once. And the key to a juicy burger is by not pressing it or not doing anything on it at all. Just leave it there, low fire, until one side is brown. You can take a look or peek into it later on. If it's brown, it has these nice grill marks, and then that's the only time you can flip it. Okay, so while we're waiting for this one to get cooked, we're gonna start sauteing our onions and then our mushrooms. Pop in our onions in there. Very quickly, just 2 minutes, and then throw in your portobello mushrooms. I'm just gonna give this a few more minutes to get fully cooked. You know, I want my burgers medium well, so 2 minutes will be fine. Then we're just gonna pan toast it. That's basically it. So we're just gonna let this rest for a few minutes. And while we're cooking this, we're gonna start preparing our foie gras. Okay, now foie gras is actually a French delicacy. It's silky and buttery. You know, you can just imagine it on your mouth, and it just changes this whole thing about food. We're just gonna slice this in half. and then pan fry it. So we're just gonna fry this for about a minute or two, or until both sides turn nice and golden. Our foie gras is cooking, just a few seconds, or actually it's already done. The most exciting part is to assemble this so that we can start eating. The truffle mayo, which I got from the marketplace by our son. So again, just like any mayo, we just spread this evenly on both sides of your buns. Okay, so I'm just gonna make one first, all right? And then next, of course, our roasted garlic mustard. They really smell so good. So you can just imagine all the flavors that are packed in this gourmet burger. Romaine lettuce for some greens. All right, okay. Next, after the greens, we have our salad tomato. Slice. Look at how juicy that is. Okay. One there. And then, of course, our Wagyu burger. And then, I'm gonna use my hands, all right? Mushrooms and onions. And then the balsamic glaze. Look at that. And hold on. This nice slice of foie gras on top. The time has come. I am gonna try my burger. Okay. I'm scared and excited at the same time because this is huge, but I know this is really delicious. Okay, let me just slice this in the middle. The moment of truth has come. Look at how juicy the meat is. And the foie gras. Okay, I'm having everything that is in here. The mushrooms and the truffle. Mmm. You know, the beef just tastes fantastic. It's really good. And then I like the earthy flavor of the mushrooms and the sweetness of the balsamic and the onions and the freshness of the salad tomato. So you can serve this with fries or maybe ice cold beer or soda. But you know what? They will all shy away from the glory that is this burger. Now this Wagyu burger with truffled mayo, foie gras, glazed onions, and mushroom is worthy to be called gourmet. This has been A Pinch of Portia.